Star Wars. De nieuwe Star Wars figuren praten echt dankzij de Comtalk Reader.
We will have revenge.
Breng Qui-Gon Jinn en zijn Comtalk chip bij de Reader.
I sense a disturbance in the force.
Luister naar Obi-Wan Kenobi.
I have a bad feeling about this.
Met de nieuwe figuren beleef je de echte Star Wars actie. Star Wars. May the Force be with you.
So that was a toy commercial for Star Wars Episode 1. You know, it showed Darth Maul, it showed Obi-Wan, and the other one, I'm forgetting his name now. The one character, I always forget his name. Like some special figures with the lightsabers and all that. It did have that other language again that the Pizza Hut commercial a second ago had. Don't ask me why I found it like this. This is just how I got it. Like, when I searched, I found this commercial. Don't ask me why it came up in its language. That's how it was. So I'm not going to do anything about it. And was there an American version? Probably. I don't know. I have no proof. I have no reason to say no. Yeah, I mean, I'm sure that it maybe existed. I'm sure those toys probably came over to America at some point. I just don't know if they made an American commercial that was completely American. I mean, the majority of the commercial was like in English, but there was definitely these moments that you were like, wait, are they trying to speak in English? Are they trying to speak in like a broken English? Like, what's going on here? Because, you know, it wasn't very clear. It wasn't, fluid English. It definitely sounded like there was this mix going on where they would speak English and they speak like some other language that, in some accent that definitely was a little bit more unusual and more unexpected. So, yeah.
Somewhere in the universe, the ultimate evil stirs. But three legendary heroes have come together and will lead the battle to save the galaxy from the menace of the dark side.
Right after lunch.
Play Defeat the Dark Side. Collect cool Star Wars game medallions and you could win cash prizes, even $1 million. Only at Taco Bell, KFC, and Pizza Hut.
Okay, so that commercial, basically, you're taking, you know, the three big companies, Taco Bell, what was it again, Pizza Hut, and you got, I think it was KFC, and it's supposed to be kind of a reference to the fourth movie with the whole entire setup and the whole entire and the lightsaber thing. Kind of funny, you know. I mean, each of these companies were, you know, representing. Each of these are the main ones that are promoting the movie, that were promoting the movie at the time. And, you know, they went out of their way to do this compilation thing where these companies kind of teamed together to do this and got their mascots. So, like, you had the Chihuahua, you had, you know, a typical Pizza Hut employee, and then you had Colonel Sanders. So, you know, there's definitely there's definitely an idea going there that they wanted to put across. I mean, each of them obviously did their own separate commercials that, you know, still promoted the whole entire fact that each of these companies are basically saying, oh yeah, we'll support this this movie as a trio. And you know, interesting, you know, definitely something that a little bit more unexpected, but still a cool commercial. Again, advertising the toys a little bit, and just in general, like, oh, if you want to go here, like, we say go watch the movie, have fun, oh, we'll make references, really cool. So yeah.
Bij aankoop van 3 zakken Smits ontvang je de gratis Jar Jar Clayton. En met de Star Wars wedstrijd kan je ook verschillende fantastische prijzen winnen. Hou je chips goed in de gaten, want jij bent niet de enige die Smits onweerstaanbaar lekker vindt.
Okay, so the next commercial is kind of like a Jar Jar Binks kind of commercial, which is expected, but unusual. Basically, it's emphasizing, like, I think it's supposed to be like a German commercial or something like that, with these kind of like chips or something, and the human uses his tongue. It's weird. It's so bizarre. Don't ask. Just a really, really bizarre commercial, and for a bizarre character like Jar Jar Binks, only logical, I guess, if you want to say that's logical. I mean, I guess it connects with the character. Sure, let's go with that. Yeah, I don't know what to tell you. Jojo Binks is not your everyday character you're gonna see and want to be best friends with. Jar Jar Binks is Jar Jar Binks. Not much else to say there. Again, I'm trying my best not to be so negative towards it, but this was definitely one of those situations where I see that I'm just like, I wouldn't say I'm negative towards it, but it's a little freaky. Not necessarily the most I'm gonna have a normal day and feel like, oh, it's no big deal. I just saw that commercial that's kind of creepy and kind of messed up. No, just maybe a little bit. I don't know. So I think there's one more commercial, guys, for episode one. I knew that this is actually shorter than 4, 5, and 6 have been with these commercials. But it should be, it's fine. This would be the la the next one will be the last one for episode one, and next time we'll get to, and then I'll talk about it during that one. So here we go, guys.
Word wakker en stap in de legende. Ontdek de 3 Star Wars Episode 1 game packs. Alleen bij Frosties van Kellogg's. Kellogg's, een legendarisch begin van de dag.
Okay, so that commercial was one for this Kellogg cereal back then. Frosties, I think it was called. Back then, they used to have a lot more of these commercials that used to advertise like movies and characters, and have characters on cereal boxes and stuff like that, and kind of be like, oh, if you want to have a cereal related to these characters, then buy this cereal. Obviously Star Wars was big at the time, so they're like, oh, let's have a cereal box that has Star Wars related, like, little pieces or something like that, and have them colored a specific way, and have certain character faces show up on the individual charms and pieces or whatever they are. So that was definitely a thing, and that's been done before in a bunch of different situations. But this was definitely one of the ones where they decided to go out of their way and do this. Whether it was good or bad, that depends on who's eating it, and if you like character-based cereal. A pretty simple commercial otherwise. Next time we will be going actually into episode 3. Unfortunately, I was not really able to find episode 2 commercials. If you guys can find some episode 2 commercials that aren't just trailer or TV spot commercials, then send them over my way or put them in the comments. But I personally could not find any commercials that weren't just TV spot or trailer commercials for episode 2, and personally I don't want to go on my way to do all that and go back and have to start from episode 4 and do all those ones, and then go to episode 5 and do all those ones, and then 6, and then do all those. And I know that I've been trying to be pretty much like chronicling everything, but at the same time it's like movies, like, yes, it makes sense to do it, but at the same time I feel like it will get a little bit too repetitive compared to let's just say if I were doing these other commercials, where sometimes they're repetitive but it's like they're tolerable. In this case it's like I've seen this movie. It's not like, oh, this is the first time I'm hearing of this movie, I've never heard of this before, and I'm excited because I want to get more information. No, I already know about this movie, so it's like I know enough. And then again, you could be saying that, well, what about the people that haven't seen it before? And I get that, but I'd rather not. I'm sorry to say, if you guys are interested, please go out, please. I would say this a million times over, either watch the movie yourself, or look up trailers, or look up previews, or look somewhere else, because I'd rather not, at least not now. Maybe in the future, but most likely not. Don't say I won't, but probably not. Like, there's a greater chance I won't. Let's just say that much. So please remember to leave a comment below. Again, I'm Crazy Scammer 71. Please tell me what you guys think of all this. Were you looking for, like, what are your thoughts on episode 1 as a whole? I know it's not particularly loved, but were these commercials interesting enough to hold your attention and keep you even remotely interested, even though they were a little bit more unusual and not necessarily from a movie that was beloved compared to 4, 5, and 6, and even 7, some of the other ones have been better. But tell me what you guys think in the comments about all this, and I'll see you guys next time. So goodbye.